Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll be talking about the difference between the demand equation and the inverse demand equation. With that said, let's get into it. So if you've been studying economics, then you'll know what the demand curve looks like. And so we have a set of axes, we have a downward sloping demand curve, and of course we have price and quantity on the y and x axes respectively. Now it's very important that you put price on the vertical axis or the y-axis and quantity on the x-axis or the horizontal axis. If you accidentally mislabel it, you'll probably find yourself losing marks on that midterm or that homework assignment. Now let's take a look at a general demand equation. So this is just a normal demand equation that you would see on a homework. QD is equal to 240 minus 5P. So this is a plain old demand equation. So QD is equal to the quantity demanded and P is equal to price. Again, there's a negative coefficient on P, and that makes sense because there's a negative relationship between QD and P as per the law of demand. Now, this is just a linear equation, hence why a demand curve is linear in this case. If I wanted to write that in functional notation, then it would be Q of P is equal to 240 minus 5P. Once again, that is not multiplication happening on the left side, that's just functional notation. Q is a function of P. That is just saying Q is the dependent and P is the independent variable, or that Q depends on P. That's the normal demand function, but what if we wanted to calculate the inverse demand function? Well, looking at this right now, I could tell you that the inverse demand function is P is equal to 48 minus 0.2Q. But the aim of this video isn't to simply tell you what the inverse function is, but rather how you can take the original demand function and turn it into the inverse demand function. And so we're going to do that step by step, starting by rewriting the original demand function. Q is equal to 240 minus 5P. Now to get the inverse demand, all I want to do is isolate for P instead of isolating for Q. So now I want P to be the dependent variable and Q to be the independent variable. And so to do that, the first step I'm going to do is switch the side of the equal sign that they're on. So the 5P is going to go to the left side of the equal sign and the Q is going to go to the right side of the equal sign. Now, anybody studying economics should know the mathematics behind switching sides of the equal sign ends up switching the sign of the coefficient. So now my 5P is positive and my Q is negative. Now you'll see that P is not quite by itself. It's being multiplied by 5. And to get rid of that multiplied by 5, I'm going to divide every term by 5. So 5P divided by 5, 240 divided by 5, and Q divided by 5. That yields me this next line, P equals 240 divided by 5 minus Q over 5. And you might be saying, well, where's the 5 that was on the left side of the equal sign? Well, 5P divided by 5 is just P. I can simplify this further by solving for 240 divided by 5, which is 48. So now I have P is equal to 48 minus 1/5 Q. And you might say, well, the previous line was Q over 5. Well, Q over 5 and 1/5 Q is the exact same thing. Now you could just leave it as this, but a lot of people don't like fractions in their inverse demand functions and they would prefer decimals if the decimal is finite. And in this case it is, so I could just turn 1/5 into 0.2, which will yield me P is equal to 48 minus 0.2 QD. Now, if I wanted to write that in functional notation, I would have P of Q is equal to 48 minus 0.2 Q. And that's simply saying that P now depends on quantity, or price depends on the quantity demanded. What you'll notice is that the red demand curve that I have on this graph is actually the red inverse demand function. And I say this because the general form of the equation of a line is y equals mx plus b. And in this case, the y variable is actually price, which is on the y-axis. And the x variable would be quantity, which is on the x-axis. But the original demand equation with QD isolated on the left is actually not what we're graphing here. We're graphing the inverse demand. So it's a little bit weird that in economics they do this. Quantity has to be on the x-axis, price has to be on the y-axis, but then what you end up graphing is the inverse demand function. However, when you solve algebraically for the demand function, you will typically use the original demand function, not the inverse. However, they are the exact same equation, just rearranged. So feel free to practice this on your own and come back to this video and follow the steps one at a time to make sure that you can solve these with any numbers. You can also take the inverse and then rearrange it to solve for the original as well. So feel free to do that. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and of course, comment in the comments section what sort of economic topics or homework questions you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.